Honorable Member C. K. Jay Kumar.
I move the resolution to oppose the Banking Regulation Amendment Bill as well as the ordinance. The Honorable Finance Minister sought approval of this House to amend the Banking Regulation Act 1949. This bill was earlier introduced in the Lok Sabha on March 3, 2020 and was not taken up for discussion. Giving some reasons, they are not realistic and acceptable. It was promulgated into order and the President has given assent on June 26. I don't know what went wrong where, in a double hurry, she had withdrawn the bill in the beginning of the first session, first day of this session, and again on the same day, within 4 hours, she reintroduced the bill in this House. I don't understand why such a hurry and what for. Presently, the cooperative banks are under the state government. The last 6 years, we have seen that this government is bent upon bringing bill after bill, amendment after amendment, simply to divest powers from the state government, and it is bent upon converting the state governments into Tahsildar office, into a Tahsildar office where this government will remain like a collector and the Tahsildar has to do everything simply by folding hands. This is what is happening even everywhere in every part. Government claims that it wants to bring cooperative banks on par with the developments in the banking sector through better management and proper regulation in them. This is the reason given on paper. But seeing the past actions of the government, the hidden agenda of this bill is to bring state cooperative banks under RBI, is to take away the deposits, the reserves from these banks, as has been done in the case of Reserve Bank of India itself. This government has taken 1.76 lakh crores on August 2019 to enable this business houses, big business houses.
Yes, please conclude.
Sir, I'll finish it, sir. Yes. Involve the agricultural sale and marketing, these things are being done. As regards the better management and proper regulation, I beg to differ here. This government has merged several banks. What had happened to them? Even after merging these banks, no tangible result has come. The Reserve Bank of India, sorry, the State Bank of India, the largest bank in the world, has gone into debt, and they are selling. Yes.